So let's just off the top give, say everybody takes five strain from being freaked out.
Okay, that puts me at five.
Puts me at five as well.
Strain?
How many?
Five strain.
Seven.
Five strain. That's just, that's either from freaking out and your heart rate jumping or also the fluids hitting you.
I have seven strain left.
You're a fresh clone.
I am.
Okay. These things come crashing in on you.
Uh-huh.
There's one door that leads out. That's the door you came through, and it leads back to that hallway, which, you know, down at the end of that hallway, you get back to that room you guys were just in, and then there's another long hallway and gathering area, and then beyond that, your ship.
We kind of came the wrong way, didn't we? We probably should just went to the ship.
Yeah, probably. Doesn't matter. Here's what I'm going to do. Wait, do we need an order? Do we need to perform an order?
I'm going to let everybody go, and then I'll tell you what the Gippies go. So if anyone wants to jump in at this point, feel free. Talene?
Okay.
Yeah, I was like,
I'm
going to
climb into my... I'm climbing onto my wheelie chair, and I'm going to push off. I'm going to tie...
So first thing I would go for, too, in a situation like this.
I'm going to tie a rope to my... to the spiky ball and tie it to the chair. And then I'm going to carry... my cattle prod.
Okay.
And you're... I'm gonna cattle prod my way through the Gippies, rolling on a wheelie chair, dragging this ball behind me to clear a space for everyone else.
I love it.
Giant spike ball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I love it.
It's perfect for those Gippies.
Yeah.
That makes sense to me. the problem is wheelie chair, giant metal spike ball's gotta weigh way more than the wheelie chair. You would just push off and you would just go wong. And like, that's it, you wouldn't go. Someone has to be like, someone has to give that thing a big push behind you.
I'll help push.
Push the giant. You know what, we should tie this spike to you.
Tie a spike ball to me.
You could dung beetle it pretty easily.
That's only something I do in private.
I feel like we don't have to use this spike ball. Can we just go?
The Gippies start getting up to their feet, but more Gippies start spilling in behind them on top of them.
We're gonna need to get the Gippies.
Get the Gippies!
Well, right. Bosley, we're gonna
shoot
need your
the
help.
Gippies!
All right, I got my blaster out. Let's shoot some Gippies.
Pop my turret out, too.
Another two strain to everybody. Ah. For you, it just represents bits and crevices getting gummed up by oozes and fluids.
Mm-hmm. Ew.
All right,
as long
the ball.
As you guys stay in this room.
Wheelie chair.
I'm at three.
Cattle
now.
Prod. Three.
Gringo's luck is triggered, but Gringo isn't present, so
is
does it
he?
Apply to Bosley?
I guess so. It's up to you.
I'm okay with that.
I'm at five, too.
Who triggered it?
Oh, yeah, let me tell you. Sorry, Dom, are you getting everybody's?
Strain.
I have strain at three.
Mm-hmm, correct.
Five.
Yep,
correct.
Well, and you're going to take strain again real quickly here if you guys don't take some action.
I did. I told you.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Wheelie chair.
I didn't. I just said I pulled out my blaster right now, but you just started straining us.
Mm-hmm. We'll start running towards the door, shooting.
I'm through running.
Pew, pew, pew.
Wait, so first of all,
I'm ready to parlay.
Haas 7866 activates Gringo's luck.
Thank you, Haas. Appreciate it.
Haas 78.
This might help or hinder us. We'll
66
see.
Also establishes himself as the anti Darth Sci Fi T Rex by giving two triumphs to Gippy.
Whoa!
Let's use these to represent your triumphs.
That's heavy.
That gives you. I'm gonna say it has to be on. No, I'm not even gonna say that. You can spend them on both on one roll if you wanted to.
Okay.
Wow. Yeah, now you gotta parlay.
My death roll. I triumph. I die triumphantly.
So, door is open. You kick that open. No one in the hallway in front of you.
Wheelie chair. Whee! But I got that cattle prod in case I run into any Gippies.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. So you just go shooting on down. You have your gun out.
Yeah, I got my blaster out, ready to go, ready to shoot some Gippies.
You got a follower?
Am I gonna follow her?
Yeah, or no, who's following who? Yeah, we do need
to follow. I'm holding the prod out.
I'm definitely in front, because I got these long legs that run real fast.
Yeah, and you can get over stuff for a lot more easily.
Running
I'm
and
sure.
shooting.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna try and parlay with the Gippies.
Are you mad?
What is Sergeant Johnston doing?
Sergeant Johnston is basically if he's climbed, if you allow it, climb on top of the spider.
I don't even notice. I'm just getting out of here.
Swirling his his ninja weapon
above. I might notice that.
And going, ride him, cowboy!
Okay. Like,
and now I definitely notice.
Well, as you guys go charging out of this facility, Yeah, no problem. You have kind of your sense is picking up mm-hmm. on where these things are. Coming down, coming up on top of you. And so you guys get out. You are in front. Yep. So you're following.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Are you the right. rear guard?
Yeah.
Or are you in front of her?
I'm right behind her.
Okay. I don't know. Does can she outrun a wheelie chair? That's nah. the only question.
And that prod.
Well, I think you bump right into the back of this guy because that wheelie chair's got to be fast.
Mm-hmm. Faster than me? With 8 legs?
I don't know. That's a good point.
8 okay. foot legs?
Well, so you guys are kind of a weird mess.
Yeah, we are.
Making your way down when
a couple
of these vents from the ceiling drop off and gippies fall out. You're going to shock prod them out of existence
yes,
in a
I
second.
Am.
Sergeant Johns is going to cut them to pieces. But before we do that, Gippy, still say, standing in the
clear! My brother! My brother! It's a trap! It's a trap! It's a trap! It is not a trap!
It's a trap!
It's the only trap is in your mind!
It's a trap?
Please! These people wish you no harm!
It's a trap!
Cease this reckless violence, and we can all enter the facility together, trap-free!
It's a trap!
Can I roll for that? Or not?
Yeah, you better roll for that.
I'll spend my triumph.
Not a trap?
You're going to spend your triumph automatically.
Yes.
So whatever you roll, you're going to have a triumph on. You're trying to convince this horde of mad clones that... Yeah.
It's leadership, right?
Yeah, that it's not a trap.
That it's not a trap, and that they should offer no resistance to whatever these kind people are about to do to them.
Well, I'm going to give you 5 purple on that, because that sounds extremely difficult.
Should okay. convince them of something easier, like, hey, if you're going to have sex and eat something,
there's a breakfast bar upstairs.
Me. Oh, okay. I was going to say become a martyr for that, but...
Oh,
yeah,
that's nice.
Or kill yourself.
I think it's funnier for them all to tacitly run into whatever murder devices you have. Okay.
Oh.
Whoa.
Oh, so...
Sweet baby Jesus.
So this is exactly what I was hoping for.
Really?
So,
and you have a triumph on that.
Yes, this is a triumph.
Bloop. Get rid of this.
This one and this one.
Yep.
Sure.
And so
turns into that.
I don't know what they're doing.
So it should be a failure, one threat, and a triumph.
We just got a serious donation from Night Steeds.
Night Steeds!
Hey.
Okay, so it's a failure. Oh, and the triumph. I'm going to say the triumph. I think the way we've done it is the triumphs that are donated don't count as an automatic success.
Right.
Okay.
But I just give you a triumph. So you have a failure, a threat, and a triumph.
Yes.
So the failure is you do not convince them that it is not a trap.
Okay. It's a trap!
It's a trap! It's a trap! It's a trap!
It's a trap! Saying that into each other.
Yeah.
And then they turn towards you, and their threat is that, they don't think you're with them at all.
Oh no, this is completely backfired.
Triumph.
Triumph.
Okay, so my triumph in this particular situation. My triumph in this particular situation is that as they all turn to me, I'm going to
trap. It's a trap.
What a trap. My triumph.
We'll come back to that.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so you guys. Couple of gippies drop down right in front. Bzam! There's charred corpse goes flying about 40 feet and then hits the ground. Yeah, another gippy like pops up out of like just like a side door opens and gippy's just like, shot, you just shoot him like 3 times in the chest and blasts like huge bloody holes out, or fluidy holes out of him and he falls down.
Fluidy holes.
You're in the lead just shooting.
Tasty.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, bolts are like bouncing around the hallway up there.
Or stabbing with my leg.
Smells delicious.
You guys reach the end, no problem, you get through that corridor, no problem. Your gun, is barrel is mm-hmm. warm and smoking and you're breathing hard and you're probably laughing maniacally. There it is. The hangar between you and your ship, and it's only filled with maybe 3 dozen gippies.
Only 3 dozen?
Okay, so my triumph
but come back
I
to you.
See the 3 dozen gippies, I see, and they're all going,
it's a trap. You didn't come with them, you're way back.
Well, I'm way back, and they're all saying, it's a trap, right? And I go,
yes, this whole place is a trap.
You go, doot! And then, and then just like all sorts of buzzsaws and gadgets strap to C4, just come out of the floor, and just as the whole facility I have rigged as a massive trap, and starts cutting through all the Bindoos in your path.
Saw style?
Yeah, oh, exactly.
Wow.
What?
And you. I just go, it's a trap. It's a trap. It's a trap.
Oh my god, wait, okay. So your Gippy had, while everyone else was running around trying to eat things, had been installing buzzsaw arms, probably dart launchers.
Yeah, all sorts of traps.
Fire pits.
That's yeah. why there was a spike ball in that office.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That explains it. Yeah. Okay. Just in this room or the entire complex?
The entire complex. It's just like Empire Strikes Back.
Yeah. I remember that.
Remember that part? Yeah.
Totally. Right. Okay, yeah, so those Gippies are sliced to horrible ribbons pretty quickly.
Thank you for the triumph.
Yeah, Gippy like tries to lunge towards you, and a boot on a stick comes swinging out the room and hits him right in the butt.
Yeah, I hope it's it's like it's half lethal and terrifying and half Home Alone, where like you just ran out of
like
objects.
Goonies.
Like yeah,
a paint can comes swinging down, hits one in the face, and you go,
yes.
Come back to you guys. So. Like three dozen, they don't seem to notice you as the door opens. It's like a distance about as long as maybe half a football field we're talking about. It's like 150 feet to cover. There's your ship. It's a giant spider monster with Sergeant Johnson on top. You walk in a roller chair with a shock rod that's smoking.
Yeah.
It smells like charred flesh.
Naturally.
You're down to two sandwiches in your pouch.
Oh no.
Because you gave him one.
Yeah, I know.
But otherwise you're doing fine.
Mm-hmm.
Everything looks like it's going to be okay until suddenly red alert alarms go off everywhere. Buzzsaw blades start jumping out of the jets of fire come shooting everywhere. Like poison gas starts like flooding in. So the Gippies jump up immediately and start running around wildly, arms flailing like Zoidberg and just getting sliced to pieces.
Yeah.
There's still plenty left alive, but now you're going to have to cross a room filled with traps and enraged Bindoos. Gippy Bindoids is what I've been calling them in my notes.
All right then.
Yeah.
Sorry. I'll use another tribe.
You've got another tribe. Tiger Planet!
Tiger Planet.
Thanks for that follow.
Oh shit, Tiger Planet.
That's a follow.
Well, that's awesome.
I would like to go to that planet. And maybe we all will.
No.
Next
no.
Go to a Tiger Planet.
I like Tiger
that.
Planet.
Tigers be.
I think I would fit in there.
Tigers are dope because you're so.
Are
fierce.
They like? Are they?
Yeah. Yeah. I look
fierce.
Cool.
Oh, you got stripes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Are they tigers or tiger people?
Mm-hmm. Tiger person planet is a different planet.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Yeah. Oh, totally.
It's gonna get yiffy up in here if we're careful. Anyway, yiffy Bindu.
Okay. Shut it down. Shut it down with the you. Okay, so a nightmare. It really does look like hell. Before it looked. Like when you were trapped with all the dead body parts and you were choking on them, that was pretty hellish, but this is just comically hellish.
Oh yeah.
People are just being chopped up by giant blade arms that are like scything pendulums. You guys all look at each other, you look around. Okay, so I'm open to what you guys want to do here. How would you guys consider crossing this place?
On my wheelie chair.
You're just going straight on ahead?
Yeah, because the blades come up, but they're not going to be higher than my wheelie chair.
For me to decide.
Oh, could they please not come higher than my wheelie chair?
Now that you said mind, it's happening.
Dang it.
In my mind, it's like full on Bugs Bunny-in level of like just contraptions that barely make sense, right? Is that about right? There's like a big block with spikes on the bottom and a spring on top just being like coming down from the roof and mashing people.
Ka-chunk, ka-chunk, ka-chunk.
Well, since I still feel guilty about, you know, Alderaan and all the other crap I've done, I'd like to, like, make a distraction to let at least these guys get through. And maybe I'll get through, too.
Distract the
Gippies.
Traps.
I can't
Gippies.
Distract the traps.
You can't distract.
But at least take half of it away.
Okay.
Is this a situation where, like, this, like, a video game where it's, like...
Video gamey.
So if you timed it right, you could get through?
Yeah.
Oh, 100%.
I feel like it's a little bit like Ocean's,
scene from
like...
Alcatraz, where Sean Connery's got to go past
the rock?
Yes. That what you call it?
That's kind of informal.
Yeah, I guess.
I have a little respect for our nation's history.
Yeah, yep, that's the one.
Alcatraz.
It is called the Rock. Movie.
It is called The Rock, you're right.
You're bitch.
It's cool.
I love
I'd take pleasure in gutting you. Boy.
Yeah, okay. Yes, it looks exactly like a video game. If you could time it exactly right, you could get through. It is also, but like a starship space hangar. So there's other things in here too. So if you want to think outside the box a little bit, I'll throw it over to you guys. It looks like there might be
feel
a catwalk
free to
or something.
Think outside.
Like that.
I feel like that's what I was thinking. I feel like there's a way to go high, right?
Yeah.
If I can climb up and get to it, get to the ship.
Okay, sounds good. We cut back to think about what skill you want to roll. Get your dice pool together. I just want to check with Gippy. Is Gippy Prime immediately sliced to pieces with all the other traps, or does he?
He just slowly waddles and like he knows exactly where to step, so just
steps around.
It. Big metal hammer comes swinging around and stops just right in front of your face. Goose slicing.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. And you're just walking down the. Yeah. Okay, great. So not even out of breath after a moment, Gippy comes up and like gives you like a slap on the back, and he's just there with you. Over to you guys. You said you wanted to make a distraction.
Yes. So would you take a deception or like coordination? How would you like that? Or skullduggery?
I'll take any of them. You tell me what you need to do and I'll tell you how hard the roll is.
I'll just do skullduggery. That seems like a thing you'd
do to distract.
This is to distract, yeah.
Skullduggery sounds great. Okay, I quickly should mention that 7866 would like to heal 2 strain on Garage.
Right. Ooh, thank you.
Nice.
Rather than Gringo's luck.
Okay, but I still have that, or is that?
No.
It sounds like a rather than, so no. Luck.
Okay, gotcha. Okay, so I don't have that anymore.
Night Steed heals each player by 3 strain.
Woo! Thank you.
Gives Talene.
Yes.
1.
I take it.
2. 3 rerolls.
Whoa!
Let it rain!
Thank you, Knight Steed.
Make it rain.
Cool. Finally, Fakwad would like to heal Talene an additional 1 strain.
Oh, Fakwad!
That puts me at 7.
No. Give me, I'm gonna flip one of these over. You're gonna roll a red and 1 purple.
Okay.
In order to distract these Bindoos.
Okay, that's against 2 green. I'm gonna use that boost that you had given me.
Yeah.
We have 1 boost?
Yeah, we all have 1 boost right now.
Okay, cool.
Yes.
I have 2. Good for you.
I need it.
I just had to brag, didn't I?
That's a fail.
Yeah. So you fail at distracting them. So you just walk silently through, right up to the ship. No one notices.
I just wasn't
loud
enough.
That's not what happens, but let's see here. So it's a fail
let's see.
With a threat? Yeah, with a 1.
With 1 threat, yeah. 1 threat.
Great, so what?
Maybe I just didn't dodge the traps well enough that I thought I would to do the distraction.
You dart forward, you leap forward, you give everybody like a, hey everybody, look at, and then wham!
Check this out,
I'm gonna trigger this now.
A big wooden mallet.
Yeah, what a better time to have Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex, this was first thing he donated.
Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex.
Would like to give it to spare, specifically to Garav.
Oh, cool! Yeah! I'm into it.
Okay, so I'm gonna use that to, I think that's exactly what happens. So you fail, so you don't manage to distract anybody, I think.
Watch out for the anti-spider cannon.
It just shoots lightsabers.
Tom, leave that one up still. I'm gonna.
Seems wasteful.
Yeah, I think, something just crushes you viciously.
Okay. A fly swatter?
Yep. Yeah.
Giant swatter.
Fly swatter.
Yeah, no, something even. Yes, fly
spike swatter.
Yeah. There's a. You just like jump out, and then there's like a. And then rolling down the corridor. You just have time to turn and look and see that giant metal spiked ball come rolling down the corridor.
Go! I'll distract! Oh no!
Smash! Right into the
Who could have guessed that it would be used against us?
Wang! Okay, so I think with the despair and everything like that.
That's gonna break the glass. That's gonna take me out.
I think that does. Definitely wipes out all of your hit points. That's going to do at least, I think that's a good 13 points of damage.
Ooh. All right, I'm at 0.
I made up this spike ball. I should guess how many damage points
with
it's
with a fail, a threat,
1.
And
a
smashes into you. You guys hear that shattering of the glass jar. as Bosley's face was being kept alive in, and then flips upside down and its legs curl like that.
Aww. I'm at zero, though.
Dead.
Yes, essentially. So
what happens to Paul Lynde, who is riding him at that
point? Oh my god, I forgot Paul Lynde was riding him. I don't know.
You in for this plan?
What does Paul Lynde do? He does have some ninja training.
Does he jump off? He's got to jump off when he sees that ball.
I just imagine him just like holding the head, just going, oh, why?
This guy I just met. It's horrible. Not even a guy.
Horrible abomination. Well, regardless, I don't think it takes Paul Lynde out.
Yeah.
Okay. I think Paul Lynde's nimble enough that he can land on his feet, but you are in the middle of a room filled with traps and aggressive Bindoos. Wild Bindu appears. And they are immediately going to start swarming him, so you're going to have your hands full.
Cool.
The two of you, what are you doing? Who wants to go? You were just charging into the room.
No. I was going to ride my wheelie chair across when I thought the saws were low and that my wheelie chair would keep me above them. Now that I'm seeing that saws come high, I'm going to rely on my own knowledge of traps, and I'm going to say, where would I put a trap? And then I'm going to be like, that's where I'd put a trap, go around it.
A damn trap expert.
Yeah. I'm a trap expert.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In fact, this would probably look fairly amateurish.
Yeah.
Didn't even use any logs.
Yeah.
There's no,
it's all electronic, and advanced. Who would have done this?
These traps would not have taken out a single stormtrooper. Not one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're too
primitive
good for this.
To take them out.
Well, be that as it may, I'm still going to need a roll from you. So this sounds like, again, a coordination check.
Oh, I would you're say using survival.
Survival, because
that's
trap
my trap
knowledge. Perfect. Kaveri, what are you going to be doing, just to jump over to you?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to be climbing up the side of the wall over there and then to get it to the catwalk to get over to the ship.
Athletics check.
Yeah.
It's a very narrow catwalk. It's almost just like a beam. Just yay wide, a few inches wide, that runs out across this entire hangar, that you're gonna have to like tightrope walk it.
Okay.
Carefully across, but it'll get you right out over the ship. But if you slip.
I'm gonna use my boost on this, and I have.
I'm gonna cut to the Ewok first.
Do it.
What's my difficulty?
Red and two purple.
Red, two purple.
Oh, I gotta flip over a dark side point to do that.
Ooh. Okay.
Bloop, 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 nope.
Yeah, I only have one left.
Yep.
Okay.
Alrighty, and I'm gonna use one of my spare boosts.
Okay.
I understand all the trap. Yeah, I totally, no,
you
I totally.
You obliterate that.
You don't.
I don't.
You fail.
I fail, but I'm swimming in advantage. Swimming in advantage.
No rerolls?
We gotta reroll that.
I got
three rerolls.
Oh,
right?
I mean, you don't have to.
Oh, too bad.
You don't have to, but I mean.
Yeah, you get one of those.
You just got that rain of rerolls.
It's a pretty big chance.
You'll get that despair, so that's fine.
See what you.
Sorry.
Despair is on my side. Another failure.
Wow. No, that's way worse.
An even worse failure.
That had no.
So just to catch us up.
Just to catch us up,
you go, okay, wait, now. No. And then chair goes out into it. And then, like, big flame shot at your head, and you have to do, like, a hard bang to the left, and all of a sudden you're on a new course, and you're calculating on the fly as you go.
That counted.
Oh!
Even better. Yes, aren't you glad I let her do it again?
All of a sudden you're going wild across the course, and it's like when you're just, like, you're playing, like, a video game, and you're, like, trying to figure it out, like you're in Bowser's Castle or whatever, and then you're just like, I gotta run full speed!
Got that
And you're just, like, doing B button, jump, jump, duck. Like the spinning fire beams are coming around.
Yeah.
But it's real life, obviously.
So it has to triumph with two spare successes.
Way to go. That's a nice. Re-roll.
That was, yeah.
Great, so you. Damn. Ooh, right. I wanted to hit you again.
Of course you did.
I know you did.
Okay, so yeah, and then it's like, you hit one Bindu and bounce
off. At first I'm like, what's the logic to these traps? This makes them, and then I see it. That I see it like it
like
all comes
Matrix
clear.
Style.
Yeah,
all
and
sudden.
I'm like, oh, I just had to be simpler in my mind. Now it is clear. Now it is like easily through all the traps. But as I go by, I just flick and disarm them. Flick, disarm them.
That's your triumph.
Yeah. And disarm them. That's my triumph.
I love it. Okay, that's great. And then right up to the ship.
Yep, right up the ramp of the ship and inside
is your.
And then I like. kind of like rolls, it's like to a nice spinning stop in the middle of the ship, and Yerp comes up to me and gives me kisses.
Oh, Yerp!
Yerp was definitely feeling some anxiety, wondering when you're gonna come back. She never left this long before. Mm-mm. Yeah, you guys a love fest in there.
Yeah.
Yerp's all up on you. You're getting covered in a whole new type of mucus.
Yes.
Ew.
This session. Kaveri.
Okay.
Because he's a Rancor, it's just, you know.
No, I got it. I just didn't need to hear that right now. All right. Cool. So as I'm climbing up, I guess I could have seen she like disabled all this stuff and run after her. So can I do that?
Yeah, so you're like, this is I'm halfway take up. All of my skill. Oh.
Great. Okay, cool. Drop so I still need to do my athletics check or whatever and then pop back
down.
Okay,
I'm done with that. I'm done with that. Athletics check, it's going to be easier because if you're just going to drop down and run after, that's fine. So just make that a purple and flip my black to make that a purple and one red.
Great. All right, so I've got...
And because you're changing your mind on what you're going to do, I'm going to give you a black setback die on that.
Because I'm mean. See how it is? I literally have all the dice now, you guys, almost. So.
All the dice. Oh,
yeah,
you do.
Full I sweep. Do.
Yeah.
Oh, so that could go any way. That's one of each.
This could go a lot of different ways. All right, cool. So.
So you drop down, you see all the traps are disarmed, you start huffing after it, and then the Bindus start to take notice. It's a trap! Without the traps to hold them at bay,
it's a success.
It's just a success.
Oh.
One success.
You hoof it across, you get to the ship as well as the Bindus start turning around paying their attention. But they seem distracted from you by the exposed brain of Bosley laying there.
Oh, I need that to live. Oh no.
It's a trap.
It's a trap.
They start closing in. Kippy.
So I finish walking down the corridor.
Hey, we have a new follow from Halliford. Haleford?
Haleford.
Haleford.
Harrison Ford is watching?
Ford.
Ooh.
It's gotta be. It's gotta be.
I'm drinking that garbage water.
I remember that.
It's all true.
Okay. Anyway. So, yeah, a giant spike metal ball just rolled past you and just smashed him.
Right.
Oh, Paul Lynde is out there as well, getting set upon by...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doing his super rave. Yeah. I'm just gonna start. It's kind of like this is a bad reference. Like the raptors in Jurassic Park 3 when they start just like barking and then like they pay attention, like they're talking to each other. That's what Gippy basically starts doing.
I definitely never watched
this.
Jurassic Park 3.
And like the other Bindus are I want them to like leave the brain alone so I can go rescue it.
Yeah.
Whoa. Uh oh. What plans does he have in store for this brain?
I mean, it looks delicious.
Okay, I will take some sort of check, obviously, for that.
Charm?
Charm would be perfect.
His brain is going to continue to be alive.
Not for much longer.
After the, does anyone know how to
it's
create
just like when your head
brain
gets
juice?
Cut off and it's going to start right now.
Thankfully, I have a preservative sac in my lower intestine.
Oh, no. Kill me. Kill me.
Oh, so gross.
You can barely control the little arm still.
You will stay alive and completely aware of your surroundings the entire time.
You do probably have a dying action you can take to do something. Let your own brain.
Okay, so what is that?
Charm against all these Gippies again, I like it. It's clever. Let's just do three purple.
It's horrific.
Okay. Not eating your brain. That's the worst thing I've ever heard.
and an automatic Gippies. Success. Okay, so that is a success.
Yes.
Two successes, flat out, I believe.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, yeah, so you distract the Gippies who are about to eat your brain.
Huh? It's a trap! It is a trap!
Trap! And then I just go. And then just like get that down. Right?
Yeah. Yep. You feel the brain sliding into your stomach.
Horror.
That's terrible.
Why does my stomach hurt all of a sudden just hearing that? It's
this disgusting. Is the worst game I've ever run.
I will let that happen as long as you eat my character sheet.
Should I do it, folks? For $5 donation.
No, don't.
Eat half of it.
Okay.
Only half is character.
I haven't eaten paper in years.
Oh, he's
in wait, years.
What is happening?
I'm dying. Can Come I, on, can let I me die the way I want to die.
Yeah. Please, please kill me. I'll do it.
Okay. All right. I will allow it as the DM.
What the heck?
Welcome to Saving Throw. This is a perfect time as...
Just this like happens. In Star Wars.
This is a
that
perfect
trash
time
water.
To mention that you can follow us on Twitter at NTMTO Podcast. You can find all the podcasts at StarWarsRPGPodcast.com. We're also on iTunes. You can rate us and leave reviews, but maybe not on this episode.
Dog space.
I'm going to rule as a DM that that's enough of the character sheet to have
eaten. Really? Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to say, having eaten any of it.
You're like, I was ready to eat the whole thing.
Well, I mean, I do have enough Cheeto dust on my hands. It's okay. It's
a man of your word. I like it.
It's actually it's probably healthier for you than the Cheeto.
I want you to live, damn it.
I don't know if that makes me live, but all right. I live the way you want me to live.
That's it. That's in Force of Fantasy Flight Games, Force of Destiny. It's an optional rule.
Yeah.
Wow. Is the Gippy Bindoo incubator?
They're just like, if you eat the character sheet, just like in episode 2, Attack of the Clones.
Okay. Well, this makes this donation by Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex hard to contemplate how this happens. So we're still in play. You guys are in the ship. I think immediately, okay, so Root is in there, and Kaveri comes in, and you see they're just... The Rancor is essentially pounced on.
Oh, I remember this Rancor. You still have her.
Yeah.
Oh, Yerp. Hello.
And he turns towards you. He recognizes you, too.
Yeah.
Were you trying to kill him before?
Oh, hey, Yerp. Yeah. No. I really meant no harm.
It was, give him a sandwich.
It was, oh, hey.
It's like entire mouth
hand.
Go yeah all
whoa,
around
whoa,
your hand.
Whoa, 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 whoa,
for a moment,
whoa, whoa,
whoa. You're totally sure it ate your hand off. You like slide it out right between the giant teeth. He looks happy at that, right?
Yeah.
And then he like snots you up with his big snotty snout.
Oh.
Turner and hooches you.
Do you have a good piloting?
What's that?
I think I'm medium. Oh no, I got four greens.
Should I delay?
Yeah. What you got? Nothing.
Yeah, if you
okay. Great.
So I can pilot if we need
to.
It
just seems like a logical time.
Yeah.
Okay.
The only pilot we had got squished by Gippy Bindoos.
Yep.
Yeah, so they're kind of.
I could pilot.
Died off screen. They might pop back. Okay, so you jump into the seat and start piloting. Make some noises and sounds as you pilot. The engines start powering on.
It does sound like a horse. Like, that's all I got. Noise. I'm so Western. So,
I guess, Gippy, as you come waddling back towards the ship ramp and you're about to step foot on it, Bosley's brain safely ensconced in your gullet. You guys hear the melodic tones drifting towards you, and then suddenly multicolored chain lash comes off of flying in from off of screen and wraps itself around your neck.
Ah!
As you are yanked back down onto the ground, and Sergeant Johnst, torn up, bleeding, the slaughtered pile of Gippies behind him that had jumped on him, probably singed and stuff like that. No, Gippies, I can't. Can you give me a little?
What do I need here? What am I doing? What am I doing?
I don't know, insane vengeance? He's gonna slaughter all the Gippies?
A Paul Lynde insane vengeance?
Yeah.
And I will bring down my vengeance upon thee with great and terrible anger.
Works for me. Okay. Yeah, so I'm not sure. We have this donation. Is this a... We have a donation from Sci-Fi T-Rex, again, Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex, to kill Gippy Bindu.
I have an idea.
I'm ready to hear it.
Okay.
Is this a good lead-in?
I think so.
Or was Paul Lynde mistaken?
Paul Lynde is choking him. He's like, wait, he's like, yeah. My clone form is at this door, but you must not kill one of the most brilliant minds in the New Republic.
Aw.
And so.
That Alderaan blowing up bastard?
It's like, no, it's like spare my body and his brain may live. And so I reach down in my gullet and it's like, I have to go to sleep now. It's time for me to go goodbye. But
With the ancient way to the Mon Cow, my body is now yours.
What?
Bless you. Bless you, scientist. Continue your genocidal great works in my name. Good night, sweet prince.
And then you just see the cataract eyes roll up into his head as John strangles and chokes him out.
That's right.
And then
that's mine.
The world is once again bright.
Oh, no.
And lit up.
Oh, God. Oh, God. What's happened? Oh, God.
So does this count?
That gets us one third of the way there.
What?
One third
what?
Of the way there.
Wait.
What is the request?
Killing Gippy? Gippy? We killed a lot of Gippy.
So that's fine. So
yeah.
Gippy's body is
however, you specifically need to die by fire.
By fire.
Oh.
So I think the traps reactivate is Sergeant Josh. That was great.
Demon and
Eden. So you wake, up. You wake up in Gippy's body, and then
flames. So yeah, now you're Gippy, but you're also burning.
The fat doesn't protect you at all.
Demon and Eden, thanks for the follow. And then
it's like the burning blubber.
I'm dying twice.
So ironically, actually, like in Revenge of the Sith,
he needs to die by fire so he can feel how my hatred and rage burn for him.
Whoa.
And as he dies, have someone kick him in his fish nuts. So Sergeant John's...
Wait, I got him!
You son of a bitch, you dirty bastard!
Yeah. I'm gonna believe nuts. Some sort of mind swap BS, he says, adjusting the mind swapping thing on his chest. And then kicks him square in the fish.
Oh, fish nuts. It hurts a lot more than human nuts. Oh.
It's the one place that's not burned.
Sergeant John. The one place the fat protected. The overhanging fat.
Oh.
And with that, Sergeant John's burned and battered, climbs onto the ship to depart.
Mission accomplished.
the thing rolls up and your body flops off of like the ramp as the ship closes behind you.
All the Gippies come to get some barbecue.
Why not?
Off, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's good.
That or like a burnt, charred, like spider Gippy is going to build a super laser now.
Oh, no.
One of the two.
Oh, man. Insane. Yeah. Great. So we get a long shot as you guys are
flying away.
Flying out of this station, which is still intact and the lights are still on inside, except, yeah, definitely the flames are visible inside. God.
God has no domain here. Have you not witnessed these horrors?
Yeah, it's true madness. Root definitely feels gazing back on this.
That was a close call.
The images of the one Gippy burning and screaming at Sergeant Jones.
We just passed through hell.
Yeah.
I don't even know how we got out. No.
By the grace of chat.
By the grace of chat.
That's right.
Which is the name of an Ewok god. It's in the shape of a droid.
Chat.
Okay, I like it. Well, that lets us, Sergeant Jones. Well, I've got to call in this to base. Informing everybody that, so he's got to call ahead. Yeah, burned and battered for a debriefing. But you know which system to set the coordinates for.
Exactly. We've got to set course for the most beautiful moon of Endor.
Setting course.
Should we tell the Ewok they just paved that for like shopping malls?
The Ewok doesn't think of the moon of Endor as home.
Oh, that's true.
The Ewok thinks of home as like Earth. Whatever the Ewok word for Earth
Interesting.
Is.
Interesting, so not quite on that. Jump to hyperspace. We cut as you guys. Jump out of hyperspace, John's just on the comm with somebody else, and there it is. There's the gas giant of Endor, and then the several moons.
But that looks familiar.
Yes. In fact, as you were looking, you probably were looking at the astrogation charts, and you're like, wait a minute. Mm-hmm. Swan neck? Open spider? Snake curve?
I know this.
I know these constellations.
Yeah.
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 I have passed through the final test.
Out of hyperspace, Sergeant Johnston, the...
I still don't understand what you mean by a final test, Root.
That's all right. You would not understand.
Yet another test.
You are nothing but a space angel.
More part of your religion again,
your
Root?
Spirit.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Spirit thing.
Uh-huh. Well, that's great. That's great news. Really? Oh, wonderful, wonderful. And you can just have it, you can have it sent right here to the station? Ah, perfect. That's perfect news. Good news, everyone. Gringo's dead.
Can't say I'm mad about that.
Aww. All right.
Gringo!
Start eating.
Gringo!
No.
Eat my character sheet.
That was Sergeant John's getting off the phone. The comm system with the base. So first of all, one thing you notice that's very different. You would have noticed this before. How long have you been off planet, off of Endor for?
Like a few years.
A few years. You were in a zoo for a little while.
Yep.
Okay, great. So this moon of Endor, this whole area, is one of the most highly militarily classified zones in the New Republic. There's a cordon, a military cordon around the planet. And as you guys come in, so there's the gas giant, there's the moon, and there is the massive debris field of the exploded second Death Star, still hanging in space where it is. And then you here and there you see like patrol crafts, little, like the Cloud City cars, zipping around. Sergeant Johnst explains the whole thing about how, touches on the details of how Alliance scientists, you know, keep this place. They're still going through the information. There's so much that can be learned. But yeah, it's basically just this massive cloud of debris. And floating out there in space as well, a small like military outpost that is the basis for all of this. And that is where he's sending you towards.
So Gringo is dead?
That's right! Oh, isn't that wonderful? They shipped his body here because I called ahead.
Wow.
Yeah, we can go down to his funeral. Well, they're getting ready for us now. Why I just got to go debrief first.
Why would Gringo's funeral be?
Out here?
No, Gringo!
Yeah, he called. I guess he called before you guys jumped to hyperspace and they had the body. Yeah, that's fine. Just send it to Endor. That's perfect. Two birds with one stone.
I'll wear my funeral rave outfit.
So the last time we saw Gringo, he was leaving to check on the casino. Because with the new, in fact, let's just cut to interior. Mm-hmm. Endor outpost, Alliance outpost.
Slash funeral parlor?
Yeah, municipal gathering hall.
Okay.
That's there. Where you would do your quick marriages and things like that before going out, assemblies. And there is a little tiny coffin sitting on the bier, open coffin. There's Gringo's body in there, all right.
I immediately go and throw myself on Gringo's body.
Well, you've got to get there first. So first couple of things we notice as you guys come in.
Are there traps in this room?
Oh, not yet. I hope not. You still have another triumph.
Oh, my gosh.
That you can spend on things. So maybe. No, first of all, as you guys come in, there's another weird spaceship docked already out there. It's hard to get military clearance. Luckily, Sergeant Johnson was able to call you in. It's a, you are dead in two forms.
Yeah.
So no one would notice this necessarily immediately, but it's a large kind of swoopy shaped craft. And then as you get closer, you can recognize it as it's a hut ship, a hut like traveling space yacht. One you have seen before, you would recognize it from Gringo's Gambles.
Yeah,
Gringo's Casino is docked there.
Yeah. Big ugly.
Yeah. And you guys get in and you guys land. Oh, thank you. Great. I actually have two donations I need to Braid.
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 Braid. Braid gives Talene one reroll.
Woohoo! Whoa. Thank you, Braid.
Today. And Rail Rain Boa gives me one reroll, taking my rerolls up to two. Dope. Well, that'll be great for this scene.
I hope your eye feels okay, Braid.
Rainbow.
Me too, Braid. Yeah, I hope it feels good.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Eye thing. Probably doesn't feel good, does it?
Probably doesn't.
You shouldn't be looking at chat.
Yeah, I'm don't look
do it,
too
Greg.
Hard.
Caress your eye.
Just listen to the melodious voice of Paul Lynde and Gippy Bindoos.
Yeah, boy, I'll soothe you right to sleep.
Yes, so as you guys arrive, I said funeral, right? Great.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, then you're walking through the funeral halls, and like, there's a guy like just installing the big flat screen monitors that are like everywhere now.
Ooh.
Yeah, and so that Trump of the Hut can be like broadcast into everything. There's Gringo's body there, and Trump who's like, there's like six in the funeral room here, and just going like, "You losers! You suck! Suck my tail! You suck!" As you like throw yourself onto the body.
I definitely immediately throw myself onto Gringo with like real like rending of my head cloth. No! No! And then I get out my knife because it's
time
traditional
to
take his heart and eat it.
Great.
To keep his courage in the tribe.
It's a little dark in here for you to do surgery. Just like light it up over top of you.
Yeah, in the background, Trump of the Hut just being like, yeah, just going on and on about how great he is. It doesn't fucking matter. Nothing, everything sucks. Trump huts are the best. Like, and other well thought out statements.
All these huts are able to make huge amounts of money. I'm changing the laws.
That's exactly what's happening. That's what he's talking about. So the last time you guys saw Gringo, he was leaving to go and try and get his casino back.
That's like that
didn't go well. No, didn't go well at all. This is my totally different hut voice that I do. The one voiced by David Putty from Seinfeld.
That's right.
Patrick Warburton. That's right.
Yeah. Patrick Warburton. This is Gringo, who looks like Murphy Brown, the hut.
That's right, who also looks like Murphy Brown, the hut. That's right, heavily rouged eyes.
It sounds like Patrick Warburton.
Yeah,
I
sounds
like
this
character.
A huge, thick lipstick going on.
A jacket with shoulder pads.
What are you
all doing? Like, hey, everybody, it's me, Gringo. The hut. Here I am.
I don't know if Yoda or Patrick Warburton is
the better impersonation that I do. Thank you. She is there with her retinue of like people to help. And so you throw yourself on Gringo and you draw your knife. And as that happens, Gringo whispers in your ear. Mm-hmm. Not surprised by that, okay.
No, wait, what does he whisper? I'm waiting to hear him whisper.
Put my heart back in my chest.
Don't fucking kill me.
And then I fall off onto the ground and start rolling around.
And then you go back to pretending you're dead. So I didn't clear any of this with you, obviously.
No, I had no idea.
What's going on?
You just eat that character sheet, God.
Yeah, that's right. Don't get too close to him, you might get hurt, says the other Toydarian, fluttering in, your childhood friend, this guy, gaunt, Durga, right?
Hold on, I wrote it down somewhere.
Pretty sure you did.
Like, Dunga.
Dunga. Dunga the Toydarian, wearing the personalized vest of that Gringo that would have.
Gringa's
Wait, I have a quick question. Can I bring Yerp again? After his critical wound kept him on the ship, or is he still on the ship with his critical wound?
Yerp is here, for sure.
Excellent.
In the room. That's right. Yeah, no, don't get too close to him. He's died in a horrible way. You know, you don't want to.
Who did it? Who did it?
Oh, what, that idiot? Yeah, I'll show you how.
Show us how?
That's right.
Well, he queues up on the,
on the all of the screens
on the flat screens, yeah.
On all the screens around us.
Yeah.
Show us how Gringo died amazingly on camera.
What, that idiot came into my casino trying to negotiate peace between us? Huh, I don't think so.
This is good. Good Patrick Warburton.
Yeah, I can't wait. I can't wait for him and Fred to go down the...
Your Fred. Hey.
It's party. Anyway, dude. It's a good Barney.
It's a good Barney. Oh, I'm doing Barney?
Barney Rebel.
Yeah, I think that's what you're doing, right?
Oh, maybe, yeah. It is pretty much Barney Rebel.
Yeah,
so I'm
gonna,
okay.
Anyway, go ahead.
Okay,
Patrick Warburton is a little bit more...
You gotta start up here and then go down.
Oh, yeah. That's... Oh, yeah.
Like,
This is why I never want him at the table.
That's what his deal is.
I know, it's my greatest failing as a DM. I need to take classes or something. But also, I don't care. I'm having fun.
No, but I like the attempt.
It's the attempt. It's all in the attempt, yeah.
Comes into my casino saying, hey, I'll wager my entire life. I put my life and my casino on the line. One game of Sabak, one hand. Whoever wins, they gotta get out of there. So if I win, I was supposed to leave. No way, backwards. If he wins, I'm supposed to leave? Nah, I don't think so. Sure, he may have won the game. He may have won it. But of course I had him killed anyway. Or I would have. If only.
Also kind of Yogi Bear, almost.
Hey, the picnic biscuits.
Hey, boo-boo.
Hey, boo-boo.
Hey, boo-boo. Hey, boo-boo. I don't know, Yogi.
Yeah, those are the other backup guys that he's got there. So, the other, like, backup hut minions that are henchmen.